Now, before returning home, Marcos visited America's Pacific Military Headquarters in Hawaii, where he raised concerns over China's reclamation activities, which he says are inching closer to Philippine shores. This report.
For the first time since 1991, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. returned to Hawaii for a short working visit. The president paid a visit to the headquarters of the U.S. Indo-Pacific Command. The command oversees all U.S. military activities in the region, which includes 36 nations and over half of the world's population. He also witnessed a capability demonstration of the West Philippine Sea support at the Joint Base Pearl Harbor Hickam. The Philippine leader also offered flowers at the USS Arizona, which was ground zero of the infamous attack of Japanese forces on Pearl Harbor during World War II. The president's visit at the U.S. Indo-Pacific Command comes amid heightening tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
Of my father,
during his remarks at the Daniel Inouye Asia-Pacific Center for Security Studies, the president highlighted the challenges faced by the Indo-Pacific region, particularly on maintaining peace in the West Philippine Sea.
Tensions in the West Philippine Sea are growing, with persistent and lawful threats and challenges against Philippine sovereign rights and jurisdiction. Our regular routine and resupply missions at Ayungin Shoal are subjective to coercive tactics and dangerous maneuvers of Coast Guard and maritime militia vessels in the West Philippine Sea, putting the lives of our people at risk.
Marcos Jr. also warned that Beijing's reclamation activities are moving closer to the Philippine coastline.
The nearest reefs that the PLA have started to show interest in, in terms of slowly using these atolls, these shoals, as a basis for building, bases really is what they are approaching, have come closer and closer to the Philippine coastline. And the nearest one is now around 60 nautical miles from the nearest Philippine coast. And this is an evolving situation.
Amid these challenges, the president reiterates that he will not give up an inch of the country's territory. He also highlighted the critical role of the United States and its allies encountering growing tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
The United States is our, I would say, our oldest and most traditional partner that has been in various forms ongoing for over 100 years. And I think it serves us well to remember that the United States is the Philippines' only treaty partner. The heightening tension in the West Philippine Sea, as we have named it, because it is generally known as the South China Sea, the increasing tensions in the South China Sea require that we partner with our allies and our friends around the world, so as to be able to come to some kind of resolution and to maintain the peace.
During the program, the president turned over financial assistance to the island of Maui to help in their rebuilding efforts following the recent devastating wildfires. Hawaii holds a special place in his heart because it is where the Marcos family was forced to spend 6 years in exile after the 1986 People Power Revolution booted them out of Malacañang. It is also where his father, Ferdinand Marcos Sr., died in 1989 after succumbing to illness. As the president wrapped up his six-day U.S. visit, he brings home with him some $672 million in investment pledges from American companies, particularly in sectors such as telecommunications, semiconductor and electronics, pharmaceutical and healthcare, artificial intelligence, and renewable energy.
China quick to react to the statements made by President Marcos. A Chinese foreign ministry spokesperson on Monday said Beijing's construction activities in the South China Sea fall within its sovereignty. She insisted that other countries have no right to make what she called irresponsible remarks. Manila and Beijing have had various confrontations in recent years as China becomes more assertive in pressing its maritime claims in the South China Sea. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. back home with high spirits after his week-long U.S. trip. In his arrival speech Monday night, Marcos boasted of what he called a productive trip. He is also bullish of more opportunities opening up in the country.
We look forward to seeing more of these partnerships materialize in the months ahead, especially with the visit of the high-level U.S. Presidential Trade and Investment Mission in March next year. And we are also co-hosting the 2024 Indo-Pacific Business Forum. Just as an explanation, the high-level business delegation that is coming is a delegation that was formed by President Biden himself, and upon the request of the Philippines to explore the different opportunities for investment and for operations here in the Philippines.
Marcos also underscored the role of the Philippines in bringing peace and stability in the Indo-Pacific region. Marcos met with his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping on the sidelines of the APEC summit, where they discussed ways forward amid tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
Despite the evolving and complex challenges, my message was one of optimism, that together with the U.S., our oldest and only treaty ally, and our growing network of other partners, we will be able to bring peace, stability, prosperity to the Indo-Pacific region. As long as our partnerships are based on mutual trust and respect for one another as sovereign equals, and that our actions are anchored in international law, including the UNCLOS and the 2016 Arbitral Award.
The National Security Council launches an investigation into popular social media platform TikTok. An NSC task force is looking into TikTok's adherence to Philippine constitutional restrictions on foreign ownership in mass media, as well as its security implications. The task force is expected to finish its probe by December, after which government is set to decide whether to ban TikTok, including on official devices used by government officials in the security sector. Other countries, including the U.S. and New Zealand, have so far banned the app over fears it shares user data with the Chinese government. Its parent company, ByteDance, has previously rejected such claims. Residents of areas in Mindanao badly hit by a strong quake last week forced to evacuate after the tremor caused ground fissures. Residents of a village in Mudan, Sarangani province fear parts of the area may collapse due to the fissures if more strong quakes or heavy rains hit the town. A local disaster official said liquefaction occurred after the earthquake. FIVOX, however, has yet to confirm if the liquefaction caused the fissures there. It has also deployed a quick response team to areas affected by the quake. Data from the NDRRMC showed more than 800 houses were damaged in the Davao region, South Cotabato, and Sarangani province due to the quake. Now let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez.
Good morning and good morning to everyone. We are currently not monitoring any low pressure area or tropical cycle within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. However, the shear line continues to affect the eastern section of Visayas. So expect a cloudy sky with scattered rain showers over Visayas, Zamboanga Peninsula, Bicol region, and Mimaropa. On the other hand, northeast monsoon continues to affect the whole Luzon, so expect a cloudy skies with light rains here in Cagayan Valley and Quezon. Expect a partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated light rains over Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon. For the rest of Mindanao, expect a generally fair weather with chances of localized thunderstorm during the afternoon and the evening. And that's the latest here at PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good morning.
Thank you very much for that, Chanel.